filtered data sources. Filtered data sources will allow you to have one overall data source and actually create views on that based on criteria. So in this case, we want to have all opportunities and list them out. But also we want to have separate lists of all the closed won opportunities and the opportunities with stage proposal price quote. So how do we do that? One option is, of course, to create multiple data sources in Salesforce and then have them all linked together. But that would mean selecting more data from Salesforce. Or now with filtered data sources, you can actually create views on the on all that only show the closed won opportunities. And this is a view on the total list of data of records we have. Okay, so let's move to our configuration screens. What I have is a data source that just selects all the opportunities that I have. Okay, so it's all the opportunities. Then I have a data source. One thing I want to mention here, this is probably not a good idea. Probably you just want to get the data sources of a certain stage, because if you have 1 million data sources, don't expect the filtered data sources to filter them out for you. So that is not a good idea to first select 1 million data opportunities and then use filtered data sources to filter them. Okay, this is just a demo, of course. Now, what we need is import our all data sources, of course. And next step is we're going to create this view via criteria on our opportunity data source. Okay, going to go to all my data sources, click the button create filter data source. And now I'm going to say this is the one that selects the closed one. Which data source do I want to filter? The all opportunities I want to filter. And I want to say the stage name should be equal to closed one. Okay, that's great. So now I have the stage name equals to closed one. Now that's fine. So let me now go back to the document and say, okay, what we want is to repeat this row for every opportunity in stage closed one. Add a config type. Let's call this table row one stage. It's going to be of type table row. I'm going to take the data source closed one. So now this filtered data source is right here. So I can just select it. The merge field, this is the how I identify the row to repeat. Okay, now next up, I'm going to add some single merge fields, of course, to show some data in the table, and then another one for the name that of the opportunity that I want to show here. Okay, and this is the name. That's it. So okay, let's save, and now let's generate. So if I now click this button, it will actually select all my opportunities. That's this list, not too big, still fits on one page, not a million records. Then it filtered out all of the closed one. So this is actually the filtered data source that I created. And previously I already created a filter data source that filters out all with stage proposal price quote. So if I look back here, that's my proposal price quote. Looks great. So this one is there, filtered on the stage name. So it actually does exactly the same as the closed one. Now, to go even a step further, I want to show all of the closed ones, but only when there are closed one data sources. So I want to remove this table when there are no closed one data. When there are no closed one opportunities. So let's see how we can do that. Can just add a config type on this merge field. Take the type table, because I want to show or hide a table. The data source should be a single data source because I just want to show it one time. So I'm going to take the data source that I have, this one, for instance. And now I want to make a decision if I want to show or hide this table depending on the number of records in the closed one data source. Okay, so I'm going to say if the if it's empty equals false, then I want to show this table. So the table is going to repeat only one time because the data source is linked to a single data source. And it's going to, even for that one record, it's going to check this criteria to see if there is actually data in the closed one data source. Okay, that should work. Now, when there is data in the closed one data source, I want to show the number of closed one records that we actually had. So let's take a look. Gonna do this here. Number of closed one. It's linked to, I'm gonna link it to the metadata data source. Then on this metadata data source, there is a calculated field called at size of the data source closed one. So that's the one I'm going to use. No formatting for now. Okay, this is the merge field where to fill it. So it's going to print out the size of the data source closed one when the parent of it, of course, decides to show the table or not. Save the server. Okay, change is done. Now if I regenerate this document, you can see all of the items here, and then you can see all of the closed one here. If I want to know how many closed one there are, there will be 17. So it filtered out 17 closed one opportunities from this list. Now let's take a look. What happens if in the data source I make a change that I know there's going to be zero closed one data source opportunities? So I'm going to say where stage name is different from closed one. So it's going to filter out all of the closed ones. So that means it should not show this table anymore. And of course, this list here should be empty. Let's take a look. No errors, and indeed it doesn't show anything, and the table below here is it's not there. Why it's not there? Because we had a criteria saying that it can only show this table when there are records in the data source closed one, and for the moment there are none because our all opportunities data source doesn't take the closed ones into account. So that's a filtered data source, and hope you enjoy it.